The CEO of a Seattle-based company made headlines back in 2015 when he announced that he'd be cutting his own pay in order to boost the salaries for all of his employees. And his name is Dan Price because he doesn't put a price on the worth of his employees. But he returned to Fox Business News to offer them some advice on what policies would actually help small businesses. And what he recommended, it shocked the Fox News host. In fact, his head nearly exploded. You're going to see his response when Dan Price actually recommends single-payer healthcare specifically to help small businesses. This is gold.
If you want to help small businesses, one of the ways to do it is to take the burden of healthcare away from those small businesses. Small businesses like mine could pay a lot more in wages and provide a better incentive for employees. Also, if we raise the minimum wage, we'll be able to then have that funnel upward with the economy. Because right now, we have a third of all American wealth stuck at the very top with the billionaires. If we can have a bottom-up economy that works for everybody, we can provide the right incentives for employees.
So you think by making it more expensive for a small business, it's going to help them?
Well, actually, when I started my small business, healthcare was one of my biggest costs, and it still is today. But that money actually comes out of my ability to pay employees higher wages. So instead of a $70,000 minimum wage, I could have an $85,000 minimum wage if we had a healthcare system that, instead of being a giveaway for the insurance companies, actually provided healthcare for people all over the place.
I absolutely applaud Dan Price. What he's doing here is so important. Fox Business, they don't like to listen to people unless they're in powerful positions, unless they're business leaders. So Dan Price is the one CEO who actually goes on Fox News and challenges their narrative. He's the only business leader who actually bursts Fox News's bubble. Because if you tune into Fox Business, they're doing nothing but propaganda at the behest of pro-corporate America. I mean, just watch 5 minutes of Stuart Varney and you'll see how they don't actually even try to appeal to normal viewers. This is all about appeasing the business class. And it's really transparent. It's despicable. So when you actually challenge their narrative, they don't know how to respond. And so even after Dan Price very clearly laid out how making this burden of healthcare go away would help small businesses, the Fox News host didn't know how else to respond. So he just says, oh, so you think that by making it more expensive for small businesses is going to help them? No, he literally just said the opposite. Were you not listening? He said, if these small businesses don't have to pay for healthcare for their employees, if this was just something that was guaranteed by the government, they would actually have more money. They could actually pay their workers more. It's like everything that Dan Price was saying, it just went in one ear and out the other. And the Fox News host just had nothing left to say, so he just reverted back to his original talking points. Oh, well, you want to hurt small businesses with Medicare for All? No, dummy, I'm literally explaining how this helps small businesses. And it's not like Dan Price is some radical socialist who's saying this, whereas, you know, other businesses wouldn't necessarily have the same opinion, because other small businesses have echoed the same exact sentiment. And as Dr. Erica Gonzalez wrote in an op-ed for The Hill, the impact the rising costs of healthcare, health expenditures reached $3.8 trillion in 2019 and are expected to rise to $6.2 trillion in 7 years, are having on Main Street is a serious threat to our economy and society. In fact, a national survey of more than 800 small business owners conducted by Small Business for America's Future found that desperate small business owners are being crushed by healthcare costs and overwhelmingly demand government action to relieve the burden. As an example of how bad the problem is, the survey found that 55% of small business owners say the cost of providing health insurance to their employees is the biggest challenge they face. And here's the kicker. The difficulty of insuring workers surpassed taxes, corporate competition, and even COVID-19. Half of survey respondents report providing health insurance as a benefit. 76% of the small business owners that do not provide insurance say it's because the cost of doing so is too high. An alarming 53% of small business owners who do offer insurance say they have considered dropping it because of the cost. Not surprising when 9 in 10 survey respondents said their health insurance costs increased over the past 4 years, with 40% responding that costs have risen by 10% or more a year. So it makes sense to suggest that a single-payer healthcare system would absolutely be a boost to small businesses. In fact, some of the candidates who I've spoken with who are running for Congress in red districts, they actually don't use the usual arguments that I make on this program to sell Medicare for All. They sell it as a tax cut for small businesses because it's technically literally that. If you alleviate this burden from small businesses, then imagine how much more money they'd have. Not just to pay their employees, but to actually expand their businesses, grow. So I think that this is a no-brainer. What's shocking to me is just the fact that a CEO said this on Fox Business News. Like, I get that this is Dan Price, and he's usually pretty based. He's known for saying awesome things like this. But, you know, it's nice to have one person at least going on Fox News and pushing back against their pro-corporate narrative. That's really, really awesome to see. And whenever I see this happening, I always feel the need to showcase it on this program because it gives me hope. And when we're in this time where, you know, the situation, the future looks bleak, to say the least, I think that we need to really celebrate the small victories. And I think that Dan Price saying this on Fox News, you know, saying this to an audience who wouldn't necessarily be receptive to this message, in and of itself, that is a victory. And I'm going to take it.